gals, and welcome to Toddler Tuesdays. Let's get started with our storytime dice. Remember, instead of rolling it, I'm just gonna throw it and catch it and see what we get. Our taco song. All right, do you remember this one, boys and girls? It was new last time, so we'll review it if we need to. I love tacos, 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 tacos. I love tacos, tacos just for me. Guacamole on my nose. Can you repeat it after me? Guacamole on my nose. Guacamole on my nose. Go ahead and repeat it. Guacamole on my nose. On my nose. On my nose. Whoa! I love tacos, 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 tacos. I love tacos, tacos just for me. Guacamole on my cheek. Repeat it. Guacamole on my cheek. On my cheek. On my cheek. Whoa! I love tacos, 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 tacos. I love tacos, tacos just for me. That's making me super hungry. Let's roll it one more time and see what we get. Slippery fish. All right, can you put your hands together like this for me for your fish? Slippery fish, slippery fish, swimming through the water. Slippery fish, slippery fish. Gulp, gulp, gulp. Oh no, it got eaten by an octopus, an octopus, swimming through the water. An octopus, an octopus. Octopus. Gulp, gulp, gulp. Oh no, it got eaten by a great white shark. Great white shark swimming through the water. A great white shark. A great white shark. Gulp, gulp, gulp. Oh no, it got eaten by. Can you put your three fingers up for the letter W? A humongous whale, a humongous whale, swimming through the water. A humongous whale, a humongous whale. Gulp, gulp, burp. Excuse me. Great job, everyone. Now it's time to thank our grown-ups for everything they do with us. Are you ready to sing with me? Sing, talk, read, write, play. Sing, talk, read, write, play. Sing, talk. Read, write, play, growing readers every day. Let's try that one more time. Sing, talk, read, write, play. Sing, talk, read, write, play. Sing, talk, read, write, play, growing readers every day. Terrific. If you have that grown up with you, give them a big hug for everything they do for you. And I'm sure that grown up will want to give you a hug right back. All right, if you'd like to read a book, clap your hands. If you'd like to read a book, clap your hands. If you'd like to read a book, have a listen and take a look. If you'd like to read a book, clap your hands. If you'd like to read a book, stomp your feet, stomp, stomp. If you'd like to read a book, stomp your feet, stomp, stomp. If you'd like to read a book, have a listen and take a look. If you'd like to read a book, stomp your feet, stomp, stomp. If you'd like to read a book, shout hooray. If you'd like to read a book, shout hooray, hooray! If you'd like to read a book, have a listen and take a look. If you'd like to read a book, shout hooray, hooray! Wonderful job, everyone. So our first story today is Dog's Colorful Day, a messy story about colors and counting by Emma Dodd. Once upon a time, there was a dog called Dog. He was white with one black spot on his left ear. At breakfast time, Dog sat under the table. Splat! A dollop of red jam landed on his back. Now Dog had two spots. One, two. After breakfast, Dog went to the park. He ran past the man painting the front door. Splish! His tail dipped into the blue paint. Now dog had three spots. One, two, three. In the park, dog rolled on the grass. Squash! The grass left a green stain on his white coat. And now dog had four spots. One, two, three, four. Dog saw a little boy eating chocolate. Scrummy! The boy gave dog a chocolatey pat. And now dog had five spots. A bee buzzed up to see what was going on. And swish, the bee dropped yellow pollen dust as it flew by. Now dog had six spots. Can you find that yellow spot on dog? Right there. Dog trotted on through the park. Splash, a drop of pink ice cream landed on his right ear. Now dog had seven spots. I wonder what flavor that ice cream is if it's pink. Maybe strawberry or bubble gum. Time to go home. A ball bounced in a puddle. Splash! A blob of gray mud stuck to dog. Now dog had eight spots. In front of the gate, dog trod on a carton of orange juice. Squish! A patch of orange appeared on his leg. Now dog had nine spots. Dog arrived home and he ran to play with Vicky. Splodge! Purple ink from Vicky's felt pen went on dog's head. Now dog had 10 spots. Vicky looked down at dog. She counted his colorful spots. Do you want to help me and Vicky count the spots? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And look at the numbers down here. Can you help me count those too? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What do you have 10 of, boys and girls? Let's think about this. Do you have 10 fingers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And you have 10 toes. But we're not going to count those because mine are pretty smelly. Vicky looked more closely. Dog had a red spot of jam, a blue blob of paint, a green stain of grass, a brown smear of chocolate, a yellow patch of pollen, a pink drop of ice cream, an orange splash of juice, a purple ink mark, a gray splodge of mud, and, of course, a black spot on his left ear. You need a bath, dog. Do you want to shake like the dog does when he gets out of the bath? Shake really hard, get all that water off. When dog went to bed, he had one black spot on his left ear. What a colorful day, dog. The end. So I love lots of colors. If you couldn't tell from my shirt today, it has all the colors of the rainbow. And this is a paint palette with a paintbrush, and it has one color on it right now. What color is on my paint palette? Red, very good. Remember, that is Miss Sarah's favorite color. So I want you to do something with me. I want you to look down at what you're wearing today and see what colors you can find in your clothes, or maybe even on your body. Maybe you have blue eyes. I have brown eyes. You might have pink lips. What other colors can you see that you're wearing today? Great job. So if your clothes have any red, put your finger on your head. If your clothes have any blue, put your finger on your shoe. If your clothes have any green, wave your hand, whoops, so you are seen. If your clothes have any yellow, smile like a happy fellow. If your clothes have any brown, turn your smile into a frown. I don't have any clothes that are brown, but my eyes are brown and my glasses are brown, so I suppose I should frown. If your clothes have any black, put your hands behind your back. And if your clothes have any white, stomp your feet with all your might. I have white on my shirt that says, be kind. Do you have white on your clothes? Make sure you stomp your feet. Great job, everyone. My two hands go clap, clap, clap. My two feet go tap, tap, tap. My two hands go thump, thump, thump. My two legs go jump, jump, jump. My one body turns around. Then I sit quietly down. Shh. Are you ready for another book? This book has a lot of colors as well. It is called Butterfly, Butterfly by Peter Hrasek. One day, Lucy saw a beautiful butterfly. She played with it and chased it all around the garden. Let's see if we can trace our finger. All around the garden. The next day, Lucy couldn't find the butterfly anywhere. Do you see? But she did find a pink earthworm wriggling along the ground and a brown spider busy spinning his web. Then Lucy discovered a green beetle and a family of very spotty red ladybugs scurrying around. She saw a snail with an orange shell slithering. And three purple caterpillars munching a leaf. Can you help me count those caterpillars? One, two, three. A shimmering blue dragonfly and a yellow bee with a stripe buzzing about. What does a bee say? Bzzz. But Lucy didn't see that butterfly anywhere. She looked and looked. Lucy lay down in the cool grass to wait. And then high in the sky, there it was, her colorful, beautiful butterfly. Look at that butterfly floating and flapping its wings. It has red, orange, yellow, green, and blue, and purple too. Look at all the colors and one beautiful butterfly. The end. Great job, everyone. So I have lots of colorful paintbrushes here. I have red, orange, yellow, green, and blue. Another word for color is hue. Can you say that with me? Hue. Good job. So I'm going to play a little game with you. Do you see all my paintbrushes? I know the colors of the rainbow. Do you know them too? If one of them was missing, would you know which hue? Let's see. Can you tell which color I took away? I had five paintbrushes and there's only four left. That's right, it was the yellow one. Let's try that again. I know the colors of the rainbow. Do you know them too? If one of them was missing, would you know which hue? Let's see. I went from five paintbrushes to four. Can you tell me which color is missing? That's right, it was the orange paintbrush. Great job guessing, everyone. Now I'm going to still use this flannel board to put up my fishbowl. And I have some very colorful fish to add to my fish bowl. What color is that fish? Right, red. And how many do I have there? Just one. One little red fish swimming in the water, swimming in the water, swimming in the water. One little red fish swimming in the water. Bubble, 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 pop. Let's see what color I change it to this time. That's right, orange. One little orange fish swimming in the water, swimming in the water, swimming in the water. One little orange fish swimming in the water. Bubble, 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 pop. Now I have one little yellow fish swimming in the water, swimming in the water, swimming in the water. One little yellow fish swimming in the water. Bubble, 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 pop. Now we have one little green fish swimming in the water, swimming in the water, swimming in the water. One little green fish swimming in the water. Bubble, 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 pop. Last one. One little purple fish swimming in the water, swimming in the water, swimming in the water. One little purple fish swimming in the water. Bubble, 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 pop. Wonderful job, everyone. All right, I think it's that time for razzmatazzma. Bim, bam, 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 razzmatazzma. Tish, tosh, tish, tosh, wallaby, woo. A bim, bam, 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 razzmatazzma. Tish, tosh, tish, tosh, wallaby, woo. Stand up, sit down, stand up again, and turn around and around. Bim, bam, 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 razzmatazzma, tish, tosh, tish, tosh, wallaby, woo. A bim, bam, 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 razzmatazzma, tish, tosh, tish, tosh, wallaby, woo. Hands on your head, hands on your knees. When you get a cold, you might sneeze. Hands on your head, hands on your knees. When you get a cold, you might sneeze. Bim, bam, 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 razzmatazzma, tish, tosh, tish, tosh, wallaby, woo. A bim, bam, 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 razzmatazzma, tish, tosh, wallaby, woo. Elbows in front, elbows in back. When you look like a duck, you say quack, quack, quack. Elbows in front, elbows in back. When you look like a duck, you say quack, quack, quack. Bim, bam, 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 razzmatazzma, tish, tosh, tish, tosh, wallaby, woo. A bim, bam, 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 razzmatazzma, tish, tosh, wallaby, woo. Whoo, have a seat, boys and girls. Great job. And now it is time for our goodbye song. So until we can be together again, where we'll get to share each other's names, we are gonna sing our goodbye song that uses lots of animal things. So, can you say goodbye like a crocodile? Snap. Can you hug like a ladybug? Can you blow a kiss like a jellyfish? And at the end, can you put your two hands together, hook your thumbs, flutter your hands to wave like a butterfly. Are you ready? See you later, alligator. After a while, crocodile. Give a hug, ladybug. Blow a kiss, jellyfish. See you soon, raccoon. Out the door, dinosaur. Take care, polar bear. Wave goodbye, butterfly. Great job, everyone. I hope you can stick around to make something fun with me today. See you in a little bit. Grown-ups, did you know that you can make colorful pasta using just a few simple ingredients? This pasta won't be good to eat, but it's great for playing, or making crafts with your child. So what you're going to need is some dried pasta, some food coloring, and a little bit of either rubbing alcohol or another type of clear alcohol. So first you're going to put a Ziploc bag inside of some sort of container, jar. I have a pitcher here. It just helps so that the bag will stand up straight. Kids, you can help by dumping in the dry pasta. And then this is a job for grown-ups, because as you can tell, it can get a little messy. We're gonna add 10 drops of food coloring. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right. And then grown-ups, you are gonna add just 1 teaspoon of rubbing alcohol or any type of clear alcohol you might have at home. Then you're gonna seal up the bag nice and tight. And then kids, this is the fun part. You get to shake it up. All right, so as you can see, it is nice and wet inside. And what you wanna do now is just sit it aside for 15 minutes. What could you do for those 15 minutes that you're waiting very patiently for your pasta? Well, you could try to draw a picture using every color in your crayon box. So you could make some green grass with a brown tree, some green leaves. Maybe I could use my black for a storm cloud that's coming, and I could use my blue for some raindrops that are falling. But I could also use my yellow because the sun starts to come out, which helps all of those flowers grow. I could have a purple flower. I could have an orange flower. I could have a ladybug like in our story with some black spots. And I think I've used all the colors. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, brown, and black. And before you know it, your 15 minutes will be up. Once your 15 minutes is up, you're going to take your pasta and you can line a cookie sheet with either parchment paper or newspaper, something that's going to soak up that little bit of extra dye. Dump your pasta out, spread it around, and then boys and girls, we have to wait again. This time we have to wait for 1 hour for all of our pasta to dry. And when you're done waiting that whole hour, you'll have nice dried pasta that you can maybe string and make a pretty necklace. You could make different pictures using the pasta just on a table. Can you build out some shapes? Oh, you know what else you could do? You could use the pasta to spell out your name. So if your name was Anna, you could make the letter A using the pasta shapes. Lots of fun things for you to do with all of this beautiful colored pasta. I hope you have a lot of fun making it together at home, and we'll see you soon.